always check your work. Sometimes we mess up. And then I'm going to distribute the negative 2. So I'm going to distribute the negative 2 with negative 4 and negative 2 times 4x. I'm going to bring down 8x first, just so I know it's down there. Negative 2 times negative 4 gives me positive 8. Negative 2 times positive 4x gives me negative 8x. And then I bring down my equal sign and my 8. Now I combine like terms. I have 8x minus 8x. So right there, I know that they're going to cancel each other out. It's going to turn into 0. I bring down my 8, and then my solution is 8 equals 8. If the numbers equal each other, that means you have infinite solutions. So this is a lot different than what we did earlier, which was elimination. But at the very end of it, you get the same answer. And once the students start to connect the concept, they understand that it's all the same. And when they're doing a problem on a test, they can pick and choose what better serves them. So the assignment is going to be systems showdown. The students that have difficulty speaking English or communicating are going to be assisted, like I previously said. And they also have their table to work with. Their seating arrangement is done by who can help who out. So sometimes it's high students with low students. So they'll be able to help each other as they go. So system showdown. The assignment is you will be working with your tables. So the tables are arranged in 4. They can break off, but they can also be together. They're arranged in 4 seats. You will be working with your tables. The person in seat 2 will be showdown captain. So this is 1, 2, 3, and 4. So this person will be the showdown captain. You will randomly select a card with a problem and place it on the table. So their cards have the problem, and there are multiple problems for them to work through. The person in C3 will be the sergeant. He will make sure that everyone is attempting the problem and say showdown once everyone is finished solving it. So everyone has a role as we're doing the lesson. The person in C4 will be the lieutenant. They will have the answer keys. And the person in C1 will be the commander-in-chief. They will determine if it's time to move on to the next problem. Everyone has a role to play, but they're all working together to find the answers. You can only move on to the next problem if everyone answered the problem correctly. If at least one person answered the problem incorrectly, work together until everyone gets it right. Everyone is trying to solve, they're trying to solve the problem. If they don't understand it, they're going to go back to it and figure out what they did wrong. They can ask the teacher, ask the instructional aid, but the goal is to have them solve it. The group work ensures that everyone has some kind of involvement in the lesson plan. So even the students that struggle with English are going to be communicating with students that speak it very well. Students that are in special needs or special education are going to be with general education students, which also serves them in developing their social skills and working with other students and being able to communicate. At the very end of all this, they'll have about 20 to 30 minutes. They're going to come together and the teacher is going to determine if they did a good job or if they did not do a good job. After that, we can evaluate and assess what are the needs, and the needs for homework, the needs for the tests, and the needs for quizzes. Thank you for listening to my lesson.